Oh my god! Keyboard building is a pain! This is an Adeli keyboard. No, it is not Among Us. It is a penguin. This 50% keyboard was in group buy back in early 2020. So sadly, it sold out everywhere, except in one store. The goal of this keyboard is to create the ultimate penguin theme build. And the keycaps that I plan to use for this won't arrive till next year due to group buys. So I guess you might as well just press like, subscribe, and ring that notification bell if you want to see those keycaps, because hey, a majority of you ain't subscribed to the channel, and if you want to see the ultimate penguin team build board, you may want to stick around for it because I am so excited. Just a heads up, this keyboard isn't cheap. It costs a lot of money, but the contents that come with it is quite reasonable for the price. It comes with its own carrying case and the cloth that protects the keyboard. The body of the keyboard is made out of metal, so it's gonna be really heavy, just be aware of that. A brass plate is included, and other important parts when doing this build. Also, I bought an FR4 plate because I want to experiment with sound. Speaking of sound, this board will be using 3 different switches because why not? So on it will be the Bobo Gums, then we have penguins for the letters, and we are also using SP Star Dark Magic Girl because why not? Just saying, doing this entire build took me 4 to 5 hours, and there was so much pain, frustration. At first, it looks simple enough, like it should be an easy build with some advanced things that is easy to do. But then came putting everything back together and things wouldn't fit. And the worst part is that the PCB likes slipping down the case, so it might get stuck and you're afraid that you might accidentally snap it. For temporary measure, I literally put a tissue underneath my board. I call it a tissue mod, but I just only put it there just so that the PCB doesn't slip too much. Oh, and speaking about the PCB, it's soldered, not hot swapped, so I will have to get that serviced at some point if I really want to use it as a daily driver. Oh shit, I haven't made it to the stabs part yet. I knew I was like missing something. I thought this is too easy. There's no way this is conveniently easy. What am I missing here? Stabs. Since my ideal keycaps ain't arriving till next year, I've decided to use some temporary ones for the time being. So what you're seeing is Infinikey Comfy, just the base kit, and it's still available to be purchased over at the Key Company. And they're really cute, they're adorable, I love the theme and aesthetics. And overall, I think my board looks great on its own, but I know it can be better, hence why I'm excited for my ideal keycaps to arrive. Maybe later down the line, I might do some modifications, like I might do some foam modding, I might have it serviced so I could have it soldered or mil-max depending on what I'm going for. And like I said earlier, have some more appropriate keycaps to go on top of it. Fun fact, this build was the first time I had to lube some stabs, and I did struggle at first, but I got used to it. TLDR, they sounded great, they felt great, there were no issues, it wasn't rattly, and I think I did a great job as a first attempt to put in screw on stab, so yay me! Anywho, this is it. This is the Adeli keyboard with Infinikey Comfy and 3 random switches that I had laying around my room. If you would like to see more keyboard builds, feel free to press like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell because I have a few more coming up next year. I will also be posting links to the parts I've used down in the description below. If you want to hear a sound test of this keyboard, feel free to tune in at the end of the video. It will be posted there. But anywho, my name is QTJ, QTJ out, and I'll see you guys next time. Ciao!